When the present Finnish government came into office, it presented a report to Parliament setting out the main elements of its transport policy. This report represents a new departure. It fits transport into the wider scheme of public policy. It naturally concentrates on transport, but also emphasizes the importance of new thinking and ways of working. It also envisions a quest for approaches that are innovative and effective. Today's tools will be useless for the challenges of tomorrow. In the 1950s, it was vital to build new infrastructure to meet the needs of a rapidly developing society with its ever-growing volumes of traffic. As a result, Finland today has a high-quality transport network covering the entire country. Now we live in a different world. The speed of change is accelerating all the time. This is reflected in the needs of people and of businesses. We must be ready to respond to change and make effective use of innovations and new technology. However, we must take the long view. In transport, this means making choices that enable us to maintain a dependable system that is based on our current and future needs and is as cost-effective as possible. The new policy, therefore, aims to promote sustainable growth, competitiveness and well-being. Transport is a service. For the competitiveness of our businesses, for our own well-being, we need good transportation links for everyone, everywhere. As our society and transport needs diversify, we clearly must rethink how we get around. The demands on the system are manifold and subject to rapid change. We must carefully weigh how we allocate resources wisely and responsibly. It is neither fair nor sustainable to offer some an unreasonably good service when others are denied even a basic one. We must focus on our more immediate needs, rather than attempting to see too far into the future. There are sure to be fresh and unexpected claims on our attention along the way. The new transport policy seeks to create opportunities for business and improve competitiveness. New traffic services that make use of information and communications technology offer great market potential. Transport can achieve synergies with other services, creating growth, jobs and well-being at regional and national levels. It is the responsibility of government to make these possibilities a reality. Trials play an important part in the development of transport policy. They can be used to test out fresh approaches and possible solutions and to involve business in the creation of innovative services. Not all trials are successful, but even our failures serve to increase our general understanding. Transport is a service that must change and develop. What will transport be like in the future? Nobody knows, but it's a journey we're all taking together.